I this man has become my most favorite gentleman.
I think I like him. He's rusty man. He's looking very nice.
Thank you. Yeah, I see you're a Stallone fan.
Yeah, I am.
So am I. But it feels good. It feels great. It's, they just asked me a question upstairs saying how difficult was it to get into that shape. But when I had an extraordinary story like that, a script like that, it took me a year, but I didn't quite realize how tough it was. It was just taking it one day at a time and thinking about the story and thinking about the release. And when I finally reached it, it was like, oh, wow, it's done. So I think for me, The Painkiller is a great story.
Alright.
Yeah.
But I mean, how much time did it take to actually make and transform that body? Because we only know you this lover boy who's done like good intelligent films and with like fantastic scripts. Just a killer actor, you know. Suddenly we see you like as Nina is coming out.
That's very upsetting, yeah. You know,
but
you only looked at you as an actor, but I hope I was. I thought I was always a star, but anyway.
I think you're an actor who has a star with
you. Thank you. No, the tough part was first to learn boxing, and then the director called me and said, you're not doing any boxing in the film, so you have to pad. So we had to unlearn boxing and learn how to pad, which is what the coaches do. And then after that, I realized that I was not an active boxer, so I had to have a physique which looked like a retired boxer, which is not as many veins and nerves popping out, but just larger size that happens over years of average use, but somebody who's had a great physique before. So I just built up in size, and that was tough. I couldn't brush my teeth in the morning. It used to be a great feeling. Now I can, but at that time I couldn't.
You need to say you've been toned down now.
A lot. Yeah, I'm not half as close to what I was.
Okay.
Yeah.
We have the entire media package you've cool, presented with us.
Right.
I am going to send you shoot up some questions, and the actor and the star is right here to answer all of them. Can
we
go on? Hi. Hi.
It's a very, very relevant, very appropriate, and probably one of the smartest questions I've heard in a long time. Yeah, because health is a combination of both, physically how fit you are and mentally how stable you are. And it's that stability that, you know, probably contributes largely to how successful and where you are in life. And when I say successful, I don't necessarily mean how big is tire and how much money are you asking for. I mean the kind of satisfaction with which you go to bed at night, okay, and that is very, very important. So for me, it was a lesson that I learned. I went to a place in Austria where I had to learn first about my body before I went into something like that, because when you go into quick bodybuilding and you don't want to put on muscles, there are repercussions to an effect like that. A, your body is not used to building up that kind of muscle. So what will happen is it will start shutting down parts of your body which is not good. Your hair starts to fall, you get wrinkles on your face and stuff like that, and you want to do it the natural way, that's probably the best. The only disadvantage is it takes a long time, so you really have to bite the bullet and say, I'm not going to do anything for a year. Mentally, extremely important, because the one thing that I learned in Austria is, you know, we've heard it, they said, sir, you're paying us a lot of money, and you've come a long way for us to teach you what we've learned in India, where they say you are what you eat. And I could run, I could just speak for 10 hours right now on the importance of the food you eat and how it has a direct implication on your mental health. And if you ask me, the best way to get that stability is to eat right, without a doubt. Without a doubt, I mean, there is no question about it. And I have enough studies done in that field to know that it is very important to eat right to be mentally stable as well. Hi.
Okay, so we know you had to be tough and, you know, gain a lot of weight for all the films Tarathuru. But were you planning to maintain this physique?
If I'm playing, my next film is, I'm allegedly, right now that we're talking about, is an encounter box. So I need to be really, really thin. Really thin. Mm-hmm. So is that you who, I don't know who asked the question.
Maya.
They're flashing, so I can't, sorry about that, ma'am. Yeah. Yeah, I need to be lean, very, very lean, so I will not be maintaining this for long.
Alright, I want to ask something.
Sure.
You have been so away from controversy. We've not heard any controversies about you. We've heard controversies about everyone. Just name it, I don't want to name who. But why is that?
Absolutely. I'm very. I'm very clever. Nobody finds
So I love Pusto Hair. So that means that the entire media here, they are going to make sure that they, you know,
that, I hope they do. There are, I'm having a very, in my opinion, my PR department is right here. And they keep saying that you have an idiotically boring reputation. So please have a couple of affairs and some stuff. So I'm saying, yeah, find somebody. Yeah, let's do that.
But how? How is that? Like, well, because, you know, by default, a lot of actors get into some controversy or some sort of social media controversy, personal controversy. How is that you have
Why aren't you having an affair? That's what you want
<Exactly. saying. laughs> Why are you having an affair?
So I'm coming back to the first answer, which is I'm clever. And I have all the vices that any normal person must be having. And it's just that, I'm trying to build up an exciting image over here, okay? So please help me with that. But
what we know of you is you...
No, I got to be honest with you, it's not easy. You're always very tempted.
It's not easy not to have an affair, or it's not easy not to get caught?
It's not easy not to have an affair. It's also not easy not to get caught. But, you know, when you're out on a foreign tour, you're shooting in... I know exactly how it happens. 15 days. Yeah, we're shooting in Switzerland, and the heroine has come with her mother, and and for the first 3 days everybody's behaving themselves, and then after that, when everything closes at 7 o'clock in the evening, and there's daylight till 11 o'clock, the demons come out. You're all like, hey, and I know somebody would say, hey, Maddie, let's go for a walk, and I know it's never going to be only a walk. You know, it's going to be.
Oh my God.
So it's either. You know,
yes,
I do. I do go for those walks. The only thing is, there's a lovely saying, a dialogue in Devil's Advocate that Al Pacino keeps saying, is, look but don't touch, touch but don't taste, taste but don't swallow. And when you're hopping from one foot to the other, wondering what to do, God is having a cosmic laugh, you know. So it is good to see how much of a Vishwamitra you can be. But then over a period of time, I realize it's not a good deal. So it's... So, I want to only say that and end it over there.
Nothing culminated out of that long walk.
Hey, you know what? Let's meet and tell you all the story. Right now, not in front of the media.
But, is there any rumors that you have heard about yourself that you found very funny? Or, like, what have you heard about? Because I've not even heard any rumors about you.
Yeah, Praseen kuch kar yaar.
No rumors. Any persona?
No, I think that I'm a very nervous guy. Okay, so I'm... My life revolves between one film to the other, and when I'm in that one film, I'm obsessed as it is. So in the interim period, I'm so nervous that I don't even, I barely go out for parties, or and I'm being a homebird. I just love to be at home. I'm changing around. So it has come to that level that my wife also says, it's time we go out and be seen some places around there. You're not running. So I think my buildup as a person, maybe I have been there, done that a lot. I've been in Bombay for 20 years, from the time I was a television actor and doing really well for himself. So I've seen a lot of this partying and fun, and maybe I'm trying to find something else now.
Okay, so now actually when you see the start of work, the work is what matters to you.
Yes, it does.
Can I just take some more questions?
Do you still get offers from the
staff? Oh, yes. What do you mean? Okay. So that is my bread and butter, and this is my dessert and pudding, but yes, I do. In fact, I am doing two films in the South. Yeah. Ma'am. You know what? I'm going to actually come out with a video, I think, which is going to tell everybody. I'm a vegetarian, all right? And there was no extra protein supplement or anything extra that I took for the physique. The disadvantage and advantage is that, when you have a high density muscles, then your nerves also need to make up for that. Else, when you go to sleep at night, one part of your body will go to sleep, will get up with pain and not be able to move that because it's gone numb, because the nerves have got pressed. So the diet that I maintained was I ate normally. The only thing that I would changed about my normal diet was that I wouldn't eat food after 6 o'clock in the evening. So I would sleep at 10, that was about 6 o'clock. I would not eat anything raw or any food after 6. That was the only change I made. But otherwise, no extra meat, no extra protein, no extra supplements, nothing. And it really worked because the body actually adapts to what you're doing physically during the day. So it was a great learning experience, I remember, because he said, I said, I'm going to work out, I need to put on muscle, should I eat more protein? He said, the most muscular animal in the forest is the ox. The only thing it eats is grass. And he says, there is enough protein in every food you eat for the body to absorb it if you want it. But the body has to decide that you want it.
If you were saying
protein shakes are going to give you muscles, then you should just pick 8 glasses of protein shake in a day. You should become muscular. But that doesn't happen because the protein is not required for the body. So those are very interesting things that I learned. And my diet had not changed at all.
Oh my God, you're such a perfect example for helping.
Yay!
Wow. Yes.
Yeah.
Hi.
Film Sala Kharoos, it took 2 years for the film to be taken by somebody. So what was the struggle?
Yeah. Oh, like it was for Tanu Vaj Manu or Rehna Hai Tere Dil Mein, all these films. What happens is, one of the reasons that I keep absenting myself from the industry is I spent a lot of time with people who are not part of the film industry. Like I golf, I would go out for rides with the rickshaw guys and just chat with them. And I just realized that over the last 10 years, they all people in terms of the kind of stories that were coming to me. We're still stuck with a lot of old formulas that work for us, but the youngsters, now if I sit and explain to them that I'm sitting beside this girl and I'm just holding her with one finger and that's got to be romance, the 13-year-old guy is like, come on, man, seriously. You know, he's having more fun on the WhatsApp than I'm having with the girl over here. So the whole journey of trying to convince producers saying, no, this will be accepted by the audience. They're smart enough. Because they all want to tell us, like when we did Tanu Vaj Manu, people didn't want to touch it because they said, yaar, ye toh 1980s ki film lag rahi hai. There's no Sheila Ki Jawani, no Bhut Munni Badnaam Hui, no Six Pack. The film stayed in the can for 8 months after being made. And nobody would touch it. It's only that suddenly one person saw it and they said, wow, actually it's got potential. And then they released it and the rest is history. So the same thing happened with Sala Kharoos also. Every time I would say it's about a female boxing, oh, the bahut yaar. Actually, it took 4 years. So they used to keep saying, "Yaar, abhi aa rahi hai Mary Kom aa rahi hai aapke liye, wo ho gaya. Abhi lady boxing ke saath kaun dikhega? Sir, aap hero nahi ho picture mein, fir kya fayda? Gaane hain, nahi hain. So a new ladki, acha matlab. So answering all those questions and assimilating all that and convincing people. Finally, I went to Raju because he's a friend. It's not because he was a great. He's a great director and producer. But when he saw my face, he asked me. I narrated the story to him and that's how he came on board. But now this film would have been made.
So which film are you more closer to, Tanu Vaj Manu or Sala Kharoos?
Oh, yaar, I'm a producer on Sala Kharoos, so definitely Sala Kharoos.
Which is your favorite film as an actor?
I would say Sala Kharoos, right? Yeah.
Okay, he's a producer coming here.
Yes.
Recently you've met
देखिए जो भी संजय के यहाँ जाते हैं उनके साथ तो फिल्में बन जाती हैं अभी नहीं अभी ऐसी कोई बात नहीं है he's like a brother to me so he's been a great support so I enjoy spending time with him and he's got enormously exciting stories to tell us right now and evenings are spent just listening to those stories
जैसे कि आज बजट भी रिलीज हो रहा है तो क्या एक्टर्स की लाइफ में भी बजट का असर पड़ता है
यार बहुत पड़ता है हाँ मतलब सर्विस टैक्स बढ़ गया कि नहीं अभी वो क्या टैक्स आ गई है सब बिल्कुल पड़ता है बट मुझे हमेशा लगता है कि जो आपका फर्ज है वो निभा दीजिए फिर आप जिंदगी आराम से जी सकते हो आई एम ऑलवेज ऑफ द ओपिनियन दैट यू माइट इट्स बेस्ट फर्स्ट टू फॉलो द रूल्स एंड देन शो वेदर यू लाइक इट और नॉट दैट्स अ डिफरेंट थिंग बट इट्स बेस्ट टू फॉलो इट तो यार सारा टैक्स काट दें हम लोगों के लिए बोले जीरो टैक्स और वो बोलें कि यू नो जिसको जैसे दुबई वगैरह में होता है कि इट्स अ यूजर्स टैक्स यू गेट यू कीप योर इनकम एंड यू जस्ट पे टैक्स फॉर व्हाटएवर यू बाय और यूज एंड दैट आई थिंक वुड हैव बीन स्मार्ट बट आई एम एन एक्टर हु हैज नो फाइनेंशियल एक्सपीरियंस सो इट्स सेड विद दैट कॉशनरी वार्निंग
यू ऑलवेज वांटेड टू बिकम एन एक्टर और
नो इन फैक्ट व्हेन आई केम टू बॉम्बे आई डिडंट इवन वांट टू I was teaching. I had a consultancy. I used to teach public speaking, communication skills, and basically from personality development.
Oh, wow.
And that's how I started off. And one of my students came and said, "Sir, agar aapko legal money chahiye jaldi se, to aap you know ye morning karo, aapko paise mil jayenge. You can set up your own office. You don't have to keep hiring buildings." That's how it started. I went with a few photographs to ZTV office, and one lady called Almaz, who I'll never forget, took those pictures. And the very next day. I got an offer to do a television series.
That's
it. It's meant to be. वो आजकल के ज़माने में ना 12-13 करोड़ में खर्च करते पब्लिसिटी में है ना तो हमारे लिए सख्त रूल होता है कि आप ऐसे बेफिजूल की बातें नहीं करेंगे वही करेंगे जो हम आपसे कहते हैं, तो इसके बारे में सही ढंग से जो है बड़े ताम झाम के साथ और फैनफेयर के साथ उसकी बातें शुरू करेंगे, थोड़ा टाइम दे देना। What a question! Why would I want to do boxing or dancing?
Okay.
It's romancing, romancing, and very easy.
There must be some people who just
do
boxing.
They must be manuts.
Okay.
Why? Why?
But, so that means the next film that is going to come up is also going to be a romantic
film. Age-appropriate romantic film, hopefully.
Okay.
I told Anand that the next sequel, if it has a triple role for me, then I will do it.
Okay.
बहुत हो गया ये डबल रोल, अभी मैं करूँगा ट्रिपल।
Yes.
Yeah. We're always together, so I know for a fact that it's a pipe dream right now. There's nothing. No, what I'm saying is the very fact, the sequel itself hasn't been written or thought out properly. It was a wish list. And Raju has 3 other scripts before that which he wants to finish. So by that time, I think it'll be the idiot's children who will be doing it. And I very doubt, at the rate that Raju does a film once, every 5 years, so 15 saal ke baad jo banegi, 3 idiots ke baad kuch bleeding hai.
So,
I don't have the qualifications, nor the patience for it. I think, it's a very fine art. It's a personally, you have to have a trait like a driver can't afford to have sleep apnea, a producer cannot afford to have impatience, which I'm full of. So I don't think I have the technical qualification nor the personality build up to be a director. So,
well, I like him as an actor.
Hey, me too. Me too.
Yes, yeah.
Yeah, sorry, the lady in the black over here. You wanted to ask
you
a question. Yeah. Thankfully now they are being wide and all encompassing in terms of the story being offered. I don't have the liberty to choose the kind of film I want to do, whether I want to do a comedy or an action. The scripts that I can do itself are a few and far between. But now they are becoming braver. They are actually much, much braver. No, because of all the other kind of films that have done well, from Piku to that is doing well. You know, they're very different stories, not necessarily the typical hero films and dance and song numbers. Every other film is making 100 crores if it's good. Neel Jana, for instance. So those kind of offers are now beginning to come, which is good. I think it's great.
You know, I've also heard that you're really organically doing a lot of films. Is that right? Like,
yeah.
Should I elaborate on that? Because
I know it's a true story. मैंने कहा यार अब ये साला करो तो नहीं बन रहा है तो चलो फार्मर ही बन
जाओ। Yeah,
it's actually very easy. And see, one of the things like I was saying, as an actor, you want to gather as much knowledge as possible. So there is this new process called hydroponics, which is something that you can grow. This is not organic.
Okay.
It's called hydroponics. So there is both. I'm doing organic as well as this, where you grow fruits and vegetables without soil. And it just grows them on water, which is a very different technology. So mera pura hafte ka to nahi, lekin 4 din ka to sabzi nikal hi jata
hai.
Yeah.
Main
bechne aaunga aapke.
Jab Bombay mein sabzi nahi mil rahi hai, unke paas sabzi mil jayegi. Yes, can I take one more question?
Yes. I'm going to meet Mike Tyson. I didn't say I want to test him. I'm just saying.
Testing now that you're trained, you're pro at it. Why not test?
It's like me being a pilot in Agde Basanti and being actually made to fly as MiG-16. This is a MiG-29. I don't think I'll take off the ground. So, Mr. Tyson is a phenomenally historic boxing figure. I think merely shaking hands with him is enough for me. ये ऐसी डचिंग करके जो है ना, ऐसा कोई वर्ड है ही नहीं, बट आई फील लाइक दैट इन फ्रंट ऑफ हिम। डचिंग मतलब जला बोल दे, इसने पंच ही कर दिया उसकी वजह से मुझे। बट इट्स एक्चुअली अ ग्रेट कॉम्प्लीमेंट दैट ही दिस investors is glad to see the film, which is something that we're hoping to show him next month. Sorry? He saw one of the reviews written by the Hindu online, and I think he is one of those guys like all true professionals who follow that every article about the profession that they're involved in. So he actually messaged one of the boxers, Olympian, who was responsible for our boxing in the Tamil film, and said, "Hey, I'd really like to see this film." And he put it on Facebook on his verified site, so that became viral for us. Yeah, so boxing. Hey, listen, yeah, I'm an actor now. I just one film ke liye kar diya bahut hai. Abhi jaake I want to try it out with other people and stuff. And if I have to try out my boxing, then it'll be a different sort of wrestling. Maybe not boxing, but I'll probably do a wrestling film with a beautiful woman. That'd be a good stuff to do.
Okay.
Yes. So, oh, sorry.
Any plans to go west?
I thought I'm in Bombay already. That's what the South guys give up. Why not? Why not? I mean, it's with the way the bloody dollar is increasing on the rupee, it'd be a good idea to earn money in some dollars there. So, yes. But like I was telling the ladies just a few minutes ago, I have to wrap my head around the fact that I need to go back to the bottom of the rung, start giving my screen test. Priyanka and Deepika are, you know, gorgeous ladies, so they're probably going to get the best offers. For me, there are dime a dozen kind of guys who are Indians who want to act and who look very good.
Yeah.
So I have to prove my mettle there and see if getting an income in dollars is going to happen, which I would like, of course.
Okay. So,
sure.
So one question is that at your family,
which means
no controversy that I can ask. How, if you have a free day, how do you spend your free day? I've heard about
the, if I'm not
mistaken.
My God, yeah, oh,
I've
wow.
I've heard about, where is the other one?
Hulk,
yes. How is that? How do you spend your day?
So, like, I have a million things that I need to do that have not been done. Mm-hmm. Like, you know, my from taking care of my dogs, to playing golf.
Yeah, Bheem is, and Hulk is a dog.
Yeah, two
dogs. Please specify.
Yeah, so yeah, I have, and I have a son to take care of and be a father as well. So,
are you a doting father?
I know I'm a doting father. I don't know if I'm a responsible enough father. I'm a sort of an absentee father for quite a bit, but I make up for all the absence when I'm with him.
Okay.
Yeah.
And I want to know future plans. How more often you're going to see the kind of roles that you're coming up with, future prospects, projects?
I'm hoping to do more films. I can't afford to do one film in 3 years anymore. So I'm hoping to do more films frequently. But now that the scripts are being written and they're beginning to write the kind of stories that I like, I think hopefully there'll be more films this year.
Have things changed since the time you've done your first movie?
Absolutely. I mean, when we did Rehna Hai Tere Dil Mein, Magna Publications was just on magazine. Now it's all over, you know, on apps, on internet, which is very good. It's, I mean, information on tap, so people tend to remember and forget very quickly. So you're talking about a whole different breed of people who are looking at films, and then they will never go to the theaters until they find the film's aspiration. So if they think with the trailer, ki bhaiya isko main ghar mein baad mein dekh lunga, you're done. So we're fighting different challenges. At the same time, people are coming back to the theaters, which was not happening when I first came, because television had taken up all the interest at that time, and people were watching Mahabharata television, and they wouldn't want to. So yeah, it's a constantly changing industry. I mean, remember Mr. Balasundar, one of the greatest doyens of direction in the South. He said something that when he joined the film industry in 1956 or something, they said the film industry is in a really bad shape, and we hope that it improves. He said it's been 50 years since now, and it's never improved.
Yeah,
he said the film industry is always in the bad state. So that's how it's been constant.
Okay. Well, I truly wish you all the success, and I want to see you more on screen. I want to. I want you to give more punches, but this time make sure that the punches are very hard on an opposite opponent of yours. But thank you so much for being here. You are fantastic. Very grounded.